Hey, my name is Ryan, and you're watching Creative Sound Lab. It's a weekly recording video show for recording tips, pointers, and off-the-wall recording techniques. Well, last week was video one of the start of the series about mastering the art of recording drums without samples. This week is about learning how to make all these mics that we stick on these drums work together. And knowing the issues of phasing and polarity really is the only chance that you have to make sure all this stuff is working together. It's actually more simple than you would think, and once you're done and you practice this maybe one or two times, you'll be able to do it in under a minute. Now, I'm actually going to be giving you the sound files from this episode and also a PDF download, so it's grouped in a folder available for you right now. If you'd like to do that, you just jump over to the link in the description or on the screen. You can download that from the download bonus library. So here's the three steps that we're going to be covering today on phase and polarity. Step one is to learn how to flip polarity to add strength in the sound. Step two is move the mics and not the tracks. Step three is choose a priority and then work from there. So let's dive in. In the art of recording drums, we have many microphones. Some of them point towards the ground, some of them point up the ceiling, some of them point towards each other, and we definitely have both issues of phasing and polarity. But we're actually going to be focusing on flipping the polarity today to address both issues. So step one is to flip the polarity to look to add strength to your sound. You may think that flipping polarity isn't shifting the timing of the wave, and it isn't, but it can still help us in that the low frequencies of two different microphones might work together instead of fighting each other. And that leads me to step two, is move the mics and not the tracks. What I mean by moving the tracks is that some people are actually taking and shifting tracks around in the DAW so they're lining up the waves to be phase coherent. I would really encourage you not to do that. We typically experience a real delay or reverb in a place like a concert hall. Having an indirect sound that is timed to be right on top of a direct sound just isn't natural. So with that said, if you need to move a sound to arrive slightly earlier in your DAW because of phasing that you don't like, then move the microphone closer to the source. Let's go into step three, which is choose the priority and then work from here. This is really the bread and butter of getting this and playing it out into action. I have some drum tracks pulled up. Let's do an initial assessment of what's going on. So let's take a look at both overheads, and what I'm going to do is pan them to the middle to make a mono signal. This way we can really hear the phasing or any sort of cancellation that happens. If it's there, we'll hear it. In a stereo mix, it may be hard to hear unless we've really developed an ear for hearing it. When we make it down to mono, we're able to really hear the cancellation. Now, I know I'm mentioning the overheads, and that's really where I like to start because that is the foundation and the outline that will be filled in. But really, the priority here of what needs to stay right side up in the polarity is the kick and, if possible, the snare. The reason is speakers are designed to push outward first, and if our loudest sound is in our drums are actually pulling the speakers inward, then anywhere our mix is heard, it'll be putting stress on that system. So take a look at this wave. You'll see a wave goes up and then down. Listen to how the sound has changed just by flipping the polarity of the wave. So believe it or not, if you're hearing a change in sound, it's actually something that your speakers are doing because they're designed to push air outward first and then go back in. So we want the kick to work with our speakers and not fight its design. That's why I've placed the priority on the kick and the snare to be right side up so that the waves are produced by the speakers pushing air outwards. So looking back at our drum tracks, we can pull up the overheads in a mono mix and then pull up the kick slowly. Let's listen to see if there's any change in that low end. If it turns out you need to make a change to the polarity, leave the kick right side up and makes the change to the overheads instead. Sometimes the kick will sound as if it's getting deeper in pitch, but it also means that it's losing punch too. I tend to listen for the punch and make sure I'm getting that. The next thing I do is pull the kick back down and bring up the snare. If you have to, go in and mess with your overhead mics. See if you can get both the kick and the snare in polarity with itself. If you're no longer in the recording phase of your project, then you just gotta flip the polarity on the snare. It's not really too big of a deal, as long as we can keep the kick right side up. The next thing I do is mute the overheads and just listen to the top and bottom snare mic by itself. Most of the time in these situations, if these two mics are of equal distance and they're the same type of microphone, then you'll get a huge change when you flip that polarity. Now, the next thing I do is move on to the high tom. Check the polarity of that. I often hear a change in this drum. Did it get louder or did it get softer in the low end of that drum? Try flipping that polarity and see if there's a change at all between the two. Next, I check the low tom. This one is always a hard one. Because of the location or maybe the distance, I don't know, but I rarely have a big change happen when I flip the polarity on this. Just pick whatever you like best. For hi-hat, I like to ignore the actual sound of the hi-hat and I listen to the snare leakage. Does the snare get fuller sounding or thinner sounding? Keep in mind that a lot of engineers use hi-hat, they'll try to be blending this in, and it will affect the snare sound. Okay, so all this stuff, you're just really gonna have to try this out and do it on your own to get the hang of it. Remember, step one is flip the polarity to add strength in the sound. The key word is strength there. It's not low end in the sound, it's to add strength in the sound. The reason I chose this word is because when sometimes you're flipping the kick or that overhead, you actually get an increase of low end. It's typically pretty deep, maybe 50 hertz, but really that is not quite as useful in a mix. So I tend to go for more of whatever the arrangement is in polarities that give me that punch, that strength of sound, and typically that's right at 80 to 100 hertz. You'll have to just go around, try this stuff your own, and I guarantee that when you practice it some, it's really not gonna be more than a few seconds for each drum. You'll make an adjustment and keep on recording. It's gonna be pretty quick for you. Once again, if you want the download tracks and you want the PDF reference guide, go ahead, check that out with the link below. I'll see you next week.